All right, this is gonna be a big one, guys. Thanks for stopping by my channel. The company called CELSYS, best known for its digital art program, Clip Studio Paint, has betrayed its users, or more specifically, its perpetual license holders. So we're gonna talk about that today. First of all, what is a perpetual license? Basically what it is you pay once, typically at a much larger rate, and you have access to unlimited updates. Several years ago, when companies like Adobe moved over to a subscription-based plan where you pay monthly, a lot of people didn't like the idea of paying perpetually, myself included. I was used to the old method of purchasing programs. You'll buy a version, you pay a little bit more of a premium fee, but you get to keep it permanently. You never have to upgrade it if you don't want to, but it still works. And usually a couple of years later, a new version comes out. You have the option at that point to purchase the new version, so on and so forth. When Adobe moved over to the subscription-based program, a lot of people didn't like that whole thing. And honestly, you know, it's really not that expensive for Adobe's monthly subscription service. When you really look at it, it's not too bad. But the idea is that if I buy something, I get to keep it. I don't have to keep paying for it. And some people just don't like to keep paying for things, myself included. That was one of the big selling points of CELSYS for their product, Clip Studio Paint, which at the time was called Manga Studio. They sold it as a lifetime perpetual license. You pay for it once, it's yours. The biggest selling point of this was that you were going to get lifetime updates. They've turned back on that promise. They've turned back on that pledge. So basically now they decided to change their business strategy and force existing perpetual license holders to buy upgrades. So I discovered this story on Verge, and we're going to take a look at that and see what's actually going on here. So pretty interesting stuff. Pretty interesting stuff. All right. It says here, when Adobe similarly moved applications like Photoshop and Illustrator onto a cloud-based software as a service model back in 2012, those who couldn't afford it or didn't want to pay for that rolling monthly or annual expense sought out new, more affordable alternatives. Clip Studio Paint Pro quickly rose in popularity thanks to having a one-time purchase price of $49.99, while a more professional version of the software with features for comic artists and animators was available for $219. And that's the version that I actually purchased, the more expensive one. I wanted to have the EX version, which is the bigger features, and it also gives you access to more of the animation tools. A customizable monthly subscription model that allowed you to adjust the features and number of devices required has been available for 99 cents a month for some time, with all three versions of the app getting free monthly updates and additional features. Clip Studio is now used across a wide variety of skill levels, from hobbyists right up to professional artists, though it should be noted that it isn't considered to be industry standard software. Trust me, a lot of professionals are using it. It doesn't matter if it's the industry standard or not. So here you've got a complaint from someone on Twitter. Here it says, Clip Studio going subscription mode has to be the worst stab in the back of the digital art community that I've seen in a long time. Paying a one-time fee was its biggest selling point. And it was. On social media, artists expressed feelings of betrayal over the new pricing structure. Many are claiming that the one-time purchase business model is a large part of its appeal. Absolutely, that's absolutely a large part of its appeal. And they didn't want to be locked into pay for a monthly or annual subscription as they would with Adobe Software Suite. Those outraged by the decision are recommending a similar digital illustration app, Krita. Listen, Krita, I've used it. It's no replacement for Clip Studio Paint, so that's not even an option. Let's move on. Pricing for the upgrade pass and the standalone version 2.0 software has yet to be revealed, but the announcement tries to reassure existing customers that update passes will be sold for a lower price than monthly usage plans. New customers will be able to sign up for a monthly subscription without already having Clip Studio Paint version 1.0, whichever version you have. The brand did specify that version 2 and onward will have a separate permanent license from version 1.0 whatever, so anyone still using one version 1.x can continue to do so for as long as their system will continue to support it. At the time of writing, it's still possible to buy and own the current version of the software, blah, 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 blah. You're basically going to continue to get the feature updates and the stability updates for version 1.0, whichever you have. However, once they move over to version 2, that's where things are getting a little bit crazy. So I'm going to move over to CELSYS's website here and let you guys take a look at that. I'll leave a link to Clip Studio Paint's update in the description below so you can check it out for yourself. And I do suggest reading it so you can get a thorough understanding of what's actually happening. I'm going to try to break it down for you because it is a little confusing at first glance. But essentially, this is the way it's going to work. It's divided into the perpetual version, which is the version 1. And as of 2023, you'll have the option of purchasing version 2.0. Now, this is where things get a little bit weird. You can buy a perpetual version of 2.0. However, you won't be able to get feature updates. The only way that you can get feature updates is if you buy the update pass. What's the purpose of buying the perpetual version if you're not getting the updates? Well, you're getting security fixes, bug fixes, basically. Consider it like the core version. You purchase Clip Studio Paint 2.0, you get the core version, and you get the perpetual bug fixes. However, you don't have access to the feature updates. If they have new brushes or new updates and features that they release for the program, you're not going to have access to those. So the only way you're going to have access to those is if you pay, in addition to that perpetual version, the update pass. The update pass is only annual. Next year when 2.0 comes out, you can buy an annual pass. You'll get the security and bug fixes. You'll get the feature updates, but you only get it until the end of the year. Once version 3 rolls around in 2024, if you're not purchasing a new update pass, you're going to lose access to that program. You're going to lose access to those features, those updates. You'll still be able to use the program itself, but it'll roll you back to version 1, which is crazy. You'll only be able to update through their update pass, but annually. Now, the reason they're doing this, obviously, is because people have been purchasing the perpetual license. When you buy it once, you're not continually buying the program. This is probably cutting into Clip Studio Paint's profits. They're trying to find a way to keep making money off this program, and it has a much larger market share than it did before. I mean, they just moved in on Photoshop's territory, and everyone's using it, so they're like, hey, we need to get a bigger chunk of this pie. And also, they want to be able to funnel those funds into developing the software itself, making it more advanced, offering new features, and so on and so forth. I understand that. I mean, that makes sense, but like, put that on the new users. There's really no use buying the perpetual version. It's a waste of money. The only thing you really need is the update pass. You're just like continually spending money on these update passes again and again and again. You know what I mean? And that's exactly what people don't want. I mean, people want to buy their program. They want to have their feature set. They want to have their tools, and they want to keep it. They don't want to lose it at the end of the year, and then everything rolls back to version 1. That's ridiculous. Why would I pay an update pass, get new tools, and then risk losing them at the end of the year? It's ridiculous. That in itself is really the thing that I hate the most about that. It's crazy, man. There's going to be a lot of people upset about this. I'm not going to pay for a yearly pass. I'm not going to pay money that just gets thrown away at the end of the year. Unless I pay more money, I'm not going to keep perpetually paying for a program. The only way this could work is if they took the strategy of the update pass and you keep the updates. Essentially, it's kind of like buying a new version of the software program. It's basically like an upgrade. It tells you on their site, if you don't renew it, you lose it. That's crazy, man. That's ridiculous. That's not cool at all. That's really messed up. People are going to feel betrayed. People are going to be upset. It's not about people just being cheapskates, although I know that's part of it. It's a big stab in the back. I'm really interested to see what CELSYS does about this. I'm wondering if they're going to stick to it, if they're going to make some changes based on the backlash. I have a feeling that it's just not going to work. For a lot of people, the one-time purchase was the major selling point. With that off the table, a lot of people are not trying to go to the subscription model. What do you think about this, though? Do you feel like this is a big stab in the back? Do you understand CELSYS' approach for this? Drop your thoughts. Let me know what you think about this. Be sure to subscribe. And as always, keep it locked. You guys have a great Monday evening. Talk to you soon.